Hi everyone! Welcome po ulit sa aking channel, English Bytes. Sorry po, ngayon lang po ulit ako nakapag-upload ng video at just what I have said before, hindi po naging maganda ang kalagayan ng aking kalusugan. At this time, I'd like to announce that I'm going to be active again in uploading videos. And my objective is para po matulungan yung atin pong mga magulang at mga estudyante na magsagot sa kanilang mga modules. Ngayon pong distance learning na ang sistema ng ating education sa DepEd. And my first topic is for English 10, Quarter 1, Module 1, Using Information Sources in Everyday Life. Ito po ay based on SLM or Self-Learning Module. Ito po yung mga module na ipinamahagi nationwide para po sa modular learning or modular distance learning. By the way, lahat po ng topic sa buong Pilipinas sa first quarter ay pare-pareho kahit na po iba't ibang klaseng distance learning. And if you want to be able to answer your modules properly, dapat po hawak ninyo ang inyong module habang dinidiscuss ko ang ating lesson ngayon. Alright, let us start with our first lesson. By the way, sa Quarter 1, Module 1, ito po ay binubuo ng apat na topic. The first lesson, for Lesson 1, is Writing News Reports. Ito po ang ating title ngayon. Pagkasunod na video, ay dito po naman sa Lesson 2, Recognizing Information from Contextualized Speech. Sa third video, Constructing Personal Informative Speech. And the fourth video is Organizing Panel Discussion in Making Decisions. And this time, we are just going to concentrate on Writing News Reports. Be ready with your modules. Alright, in this lesson, you will congregate the communicative competence, that is to use information from news reports, speeches, informative talks, panel discussions, etc. in everyday life. Now, in this lesson also, you are going to use information from various sources such as news reports, speeches, informative talks, panel discussions, etc. that can be used in everyday life and also promote the interest and sense of responsibility in validating the quality of information needed in academic and personal use. Another one is to develop the abilities to organize information and construct it into text. Now, let us proceed with Lesson 1, Writing News Reports. Using information from news reports is important since the purpose is to inform readers, especially about events that are around us and may also affect us. Ang kahalagahan po ng writing news report, ito po ay nagbibigay na sa ating mga estudyante ng kakayahan para magbigay ng makasulat at makagawa ng mga news reports. It can make you feel connected too, but conflict of interest may arise the way news is reported. Kapag nagiging bias yung reporter, yan po ang nagiging hindi magandang pakinggan. That's why news reports have a certain structure that you need to follow to ensure you can find the most important information quickly. Ang reporter dapat ay nagiging tapat sa kanyang mga nire-report. Hindi dapat maging selective or biased. Now, in this lesson, you will use information from news reports. You will accomplish this diverse task in completing news report plans with code facts using contents to order and separate information. Now, at the end of this lesson, you are expected to use information from news reports that can be used in everyday life. Promote the interest and sense of responsibility of the learners in validating the quality of information needed in academic and personal use by writing news. And develop the abilities to organize information and construct it into text. While I have said a while ago, ihanda po ninyo ang inyong mga module sapagkat habang pinapaliwanag ko, ay ibibigay ko rin po ang pwedeng maging tamang sagot. Okay. Now imagine you are the said reporter. As a reporter, you should aim to write news reports that are truthful. Pag sinabi natin truthful, ito yung tama, fair, balanced, and interesting. How will you begin your news report? Which information will you include in the middle section? Alin bang ilalagay mo sa bandang gitna? And how will you end your report? Paano mo tatapusin yung iyong report? And what do you need to remember about using paragraphs in news reports? Ano ang mga dapat mong tandaan kapag ikay gumagawa ng paragraph sa iyong news report? Alright, let us proceed to activity 1.1. Ang ating headline, 22.7 million shabu seized, 50 suspects nabbed from June 15 to 20. Ito ang ating headline. Now, predict the content and find out the facts about the whole story. Write questions about the story on a separate sheet. For example, what took place? Alright, ang instruction dito, gagawa kayo ng mga questions sa separate sheet of paper. For example, what took place? Ano ang nangyari? Construct questions as many as you can. Gagawa kayo ng mga questions. Below are the answers for the possible questions. Sa mga questions na gagawin ninyo, nandito na ang mga answers. So, ang gagamitin yung mga questions ay yung mga who, what, where, when, how, and why. Ang tawag dyan ay 5W and 1 why questions. Ang una answer, authorities says around 22.7 million pesos worth of suspected illegal drugs and arrested 50 suspects in intensified operations nationwide in a week. Alright, ito na yung pinaka-answer sa questions na gagawin ninyo. Ngayon, kung gagamitin ninyo yung question na who or how, pwede ganito ang maging questions ninyo. How many suspects were arrested by the authorities? Ayan. Yan ay kung gagamitin ninyo yung how. Kung when naman ang gagamitin ninyo, pwede ito. When did the Philippine National Police arrested the drug suspects? Or when did the Philippine National Police arrest the drug suspects? Ito ay dito sa number 2. And then, babasahin ninyo ito. Gagawa kayo ng questions dito kung dito. Sa unang one, sa number 1, pwede kayong gumamit ng ito dito. Tungkol dito sa amount, what is the amount of this suspected illegal drugs by the police? What is the amount? O kaya, how many? Yeah, kasi meron dito lang nakalagay eh. 50 suspects were arrested. So, ang question dapat dito ay, how many suspects were arrested? Ayan. Okay, sa number 2, pwede ang question nyo dito, when did the Philippine National Police arrest the drug suspects? Ayan. And then, sa number 3, ito, marami rin itong pwedeng itanong. Pwede kayong gumamit ng who is the PNP chief? Ayan, nabanggit kasi rito itong General Archie Gamboa. So, pwede kayong gumamit ng who. Who is the PNP chief of the Philippines? Yan. And then, ang isa pa, what is the worth of the marijuana plants which were uprooted by the authorities? Yan. And then, another, dito, how old is the drug suspect? Ayan o, 18-year-old drug suspect. So, ang question nyo rito ay pwedeng ganito. How old is the drug suspect arrested with 11.6 million worth of shabu? Okay. Dito sa number 4, pwedeng ganito. What is the worth of the marijuana plants which were uprooted by the authorities? Ayan. What is the worth? Okay. Remember, ang pinapasulat sa inyo rito ay questions. Dahil ang nakalagay dito ay mga answer na. Okay, let us now proceed. Next. This time, you will go through the process of developing ideas and collecting and organizing information. You will use the information you have gathered in composing a news report to go with the headline. Use the questions that you crafted out of each answer to decide what order you will put the information in. Okay, sa activity 1.2, tingnan ninyo lang sa inyong mga modules. Activity 1.2, using the answers for activity 1.1 to your questions, write the report and make sure to include all the information from your questions. Write your answers on a worksheet provided for you. So, gagawa kayo rito ng news report based doon sa answers sa activity sa 1.1. Okay. So, mag-iiba-iba ang inyong mga answer dito. Okay. Mabibigay ako sa inyo ng sample na answer. You should listen carefully habang binabasa ko sa inyo ang pwedeng maging answer. Okay. Authorities says around 22.7 million pesos worth of suspected illegal drugs and arrested 50 suspects in intensified operations nationwide in a week. Okay, nakuha ninyo yan? Ito pang karugtong. Philippine National Police Chief General Archie Gamboa commended the PNP Drug Enforcement Group or PDEG and Police Regional Offices for their sustained operations against the illegal drug trade in the country, while the National Capital Region Police Office or NCRPO intensified its illegal drugs drive with bypass in Parañaque, Caloocan, Navotas, Quezon City, Marikina, Pasig, Manila, Taguig, and Las Piñas. Okay, dapat habang binabasa ko ito, ay sinusulat ninyo. O kaya, ang pinakamadali, ay i-download ninyo itong video at i-replay ninyo para maisulat ninyo ang answer. Okay, continuation. Among the highlights of week-long accomplishments of the PNP include the arrest of two drug suspects by officers of the District Drug Enforcement Unit of the Northern Police District for carrying 1.36 million pesos worth of shabu from a drug suspect in a bypass launch by the Drug Enforcement Unit of the Tacloban City Police Office last July 19. Last June 18, an 18-year-old drug suspect who considered as a high-value target, was arrested along with his partner caught with 11.6 million worth of shabu. Meanwhile, operatives of the Tinglayan Municipal Police Station uprooted and burned on-site last June 15 around 13,500 fully grown marijuana plants worth around 2.8 million pesos that were planted by an unidentified suspects on 1,100 square meter lot in Barangay Tulgao, West Tinglayan, Kalinga. Alright, let us now proceed to the next one. What is it? Now follow this guide in writing the news report. These are the parts of the news report. Una, part of news report. News reports begin with a catchy headline. Pag sinabing catchy, ito yung nakakatawag pansin na headline. Headline is the heading at the top of an article or page. Ito yung tinatawag nating title ng story or title ng news report in a newspaper or magazine. Example, COVID-19 deaths soar high in Cebu City. Ito ang sample ng headline. Next is the lead paragraph. Lead paragraph informs the reader of the most important aspects of the story as soon as possible. Pag sinabi natin lead paragraph, ito yung unang paragraph sa news report na sa ibaba ng title or headline. The lead paragraph is often the only part of the story that people read. Okay, dito sa lead paragraph, usually, nandito na rin itong mga questions na ito. Itong who, what, when, where, why, and how. Itong pinaka-importante rito, itong who, what, when, at where. Itong why at how, ito ay isinasama kapag may malaki pang space, kapag marami pang space. Pero usually, itong apat na ito, who, what, when, where, ito yung nakalagay sa lead paragraph. Kasi ito yung unang paragraph. Okay, next. Body. Body of the news report gives more details and provides more information about the why and how of the story. At ang sinasabi ko ngayon na, pag hindi na, wala na ang space, dito sa body nilalagay ang why at saka how. Kasi ito ay mahabang salaysay na ito. Itong why and how. So, itong kasagutan sa why and how ay dito makikita sa body. Now, next part of news report is tail. Tail contains the less important information which is often omitted by the newspaper editor if there is not enough space left in the newspaper. Ito yung bahagi ng news report na kadalasan hindi na isinasama kasi hindi naman siya masyadong importante. Okay. We have hints. Your news report should be easy to understand. Dapat ay madaling maintindihan. Every news story should be able to be read by a 12-year-old learner. Dapat kahit na 12-year-old lang, ay pwede niyang mabasa at pwede na rin niyang maintindihan. Try to be fair. Include both sides of the story. Dapat ay maging patas sa pagbibigay ng kwento. Hindi yung nakakita ng maliit na ahas kapag naisulat na sa news report, yung ahas ay nagiging malaki na. Mahaba na siya. Yung 1 meter, nagiging 2 meters na. Eh, hindi dapat ganon. Dapat ay magiging fair, truthful sa ating mga news report. And don't let your opinion get in the way of reporting the facts. Ito ang kadalasan na napapansin sa mga news report ng mga reporters sa radio at sa TV. Kung minsan, yung sarili nilang opinion ang sinasabi. Kahit na hindi umamin yung suspect, sinasabi na umamin daw ang suspect. Ayan. Ayan ay opinion na ginagawang parang totoo. Okay, activity 1.3. Use the guide questions to track the information in activity 1 needed in making news report. Write your answers on the worksheet provided for you. Now, so number 1, what is the headline of the story? Ano ba yung headline sa una nating nabasa sa lesson 1, activity 1? The headline is 22.7 million shabu seized, 50 suspects nabbed from June 15 to 20. Yan ang sagot dito sa what is the headline of the story. I hope you are able to cope up with this. Dapat hawak ninyo yung inyong module. At meron na rin kayong separate answer sheet para sinusulat na ninyo yung answer dito. Kasi number 2, what is the lead of the story? Okay, the lead of the story is statement number 3, activity 1.1. So, tingnan niyo yun doon. And then, sa number 3, what happened? What is all about the news? Ano ba ang nangyari? Okay, kailangan ibibigay ninyo ang sarili ninyong sagot dito. Mag-iiba-iba kasi ang mga sagot. Wala rito ang eksaktong sagot. Iba-iba. Depende sa inyong pananaw. Okay, next. What's more? Sa activity 1.4. Direction. Fill in the blanks with the appropriate word that best completes the statement. Number 1. The blank informs the reader of the most important aspects of the story as soon as possible. Okay, ano ba ang sagot sa number 1? Ito ay lead paragraph. Okay, I hope you have copied that. Lead paragraph for number 1. Number 2, the blank contains the less important information which is often omitted by the news editor if there is not enough space left in the news in the newspaper, ano ba yung tinatanggal kapag wala ng space sa news report? Yung kanyang ating unang binasa, yun ang tail. Okay, dito ha, sa number 2 ay tail, T-A-I-L. Number 3, a blank is the structure of the news report. Sa news report, nag-uumpisa din siya sa title, di ba? Ang title ang pinakamahalaga. Masunod, anong magsusunod sa title? Yun na yung heading. Okay. Yung title, yun ang ating headline. And then, alright, so activity 1.4. Oh, number 1, answer dito ay lead paragraph. Number 1, lead paragraph. And then number 2 is tail. And number 3 is inverted pyramid. From the most important to the least important. Yan. Pag sinabi natin inverted pyramid, para siyang pyramid na baligtad. Okay. Yung pinakamahalaga ang nasa taas. Kaya, bali yung pinaka, yung dulo niya nasa taas. And then number 4, the blank gives more details and provides more information about the Hawaii and how of the story. So number 4, ano ba yun? Nagbibigay ng buong detalye at information tungkol sa why and how. Yan yung okay, body. And now for number 5. Blank is a heading at the top of an article. Ano ba yung nasa pinakataas ng article? Or newspaper, or page of the newspaper or magazine. Yan yung headline. Okay. Now, what I have learned. Activity 1.5. Read the following part of the news story. Identify what part is it. Use the answer sheet provided for you. So number 1, ano bang part of the story ito? The million to one shot came in. Hail froze over. A month of Sundays hit the calendar. Don Larson today pitch a no hit, no run. No man reached first game in a World Series. So number 1, ito ang lead paragraph. Okay. Ito yung unang-unang paragraph sa taas sa isang news report. Number 2, dead body found at the museum. Curator suspected. Okay, this is the headline. Number 2, ito na yung headline. Ang pinaka-title ng news report. Now, for items 3 to 5, briefly describe the factual content of the story related to the news report. Write your answer on the answer sheet provided for you. Okay. Who is involved? Ito yung 3 to 5. By the way, nakaroon dito ng typographical error. Dito dapat ay 3, 4, and 5. Now, let us just answer this. Who is involved? 50 shabu suspects. Ayan. Ito ang number 3. 50 shabu suspects nabbed by PNP. Ayan. Ito. Dito. Ito pinaka number 3 natin. 50 shabu suspects nabbed by the PNP. And then what took place? Dito. Ang sagot dito. What took place? On June 15 to 2020, PNP arrested the 50 suspects and intensified its illegal drugs drive with bypass in the aforementioned place. Ayan. Ito yung sagot dito sa what took place. And then, when did it take place? It is a series of bypass operations from June 15 to 2020. The answer? June 15 to 20. Year 2020. Okay. Now for activity 1.6, select from one from the list of six categories that might be created using the newspaper, such as countries, weather events, sports events, fashion trends, movies, and science and technology updates. Now search the newspaper for information related from the category that you have chosen, and write a report for the radio or TV about the said information. Don't forget to validate your news report. Make sure it's truthful, fair, balanced, and interesting. You could record your video. This is if you have access to a camera or mobile phone. Now, sa activity 1.6, gagawa kayo ng sarili ninyong news report. Pwede kayong kumuha sa mga magazines, sa newspapers, current newspapers, or kung meron kayong access sa internet, pwede kayong kumuha sa internet. Say for example, sa Yahoo News. Yan, pwede nyo i-copy-paste lang yung mga report doon. And then, try to edit your report. And try to make it truthful. At dapat lalabas ito na talagang sa inyo. And remember, it should be truthful, fair, balanced, and interesting. And then, you can send it to your subject teachers. Pwede nyong isend through messenger sa inyong mga subject teachers. Alright. Now, so much for this lesson. I hope you have learned in this video. Nakagawa kayo ng mga, naisulat ninyo ang mga answer. At sa second video, ay i-discuss ko naman ang second lesson. Now, if you have, again, if you have not yet subscribed in this channel, paki-subscribe, and then paki-share na rin po para mas marami pang matuto. By the way, as I have said, ginawa ko ang video ng ito para matulungan ang mga parents na maggabay sa kanilang mga anak na mga estudyante, at para rin po sa mga estudyante para sila makasagot sa kanilang mga activity sheets sa kanilang mga module. Thank you very much for watching. See you again on my next video.